Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and hi everyone. This is video number 4 for chapter 5.2 on the geographic filing method. So the last part, or the last video for part of chapter 5.2, is on the filing procedure and how to expand and when to expand the geographic filing method. So basically, you had learned that we have 7 steps on the filing procedures, and it's been alter or customize for the geographic filing procedures, at which we have the inspecting, coding, preparing cross references, sorting, and lastly is filing. So let's we have look one by one. So here we have 5 step or 5 step involved in the geographic filing procedures. So don't get confused. Okay, if the question asks you for the basic filing procedure, the answer will be 6. Okay, while for the geographic filing procedures, we only have 5. Okay, so begin with the inspecting, at which you will inspect each of the incoming letter. Be sure it has a releaser for filing. Maksudnya, seperti biasa, bila kita dapat surat, surat yang diterima, kita kena pastikan surat tu ada release mark. Release mark menunjukkan surat tu telah dibaca dan tindakan telah diambil. So, when that release mark appear, you must check the dates on that particular correspondent. Okay, if there is no dates appear on the record, write or stamp the current date on the record for filing purposes. Bila kita terima surat, kalau ingat lagi, kita kena chop, di mana dalam chop atau kita panggil timestamp, dia kena ada tarikh terima. Walaupun surat tu dah ada tarikh surat, tapi kita kena ada tarikh terima. Alright, and the second step in the geographic filing procedures is the coding. Okay, coding is a whereby, okay, you will have similar with the other subject ataupun personal's name and business name. For the geographic locations, okay, you need to consider the first part of the filing segment, so mark the location clearly. Alright, so you will circle the geographic units in the name, and the number them to shows their rank in the index order. Usually we will begin the major geographic unit and followed by the small geographic units. Okay, as you can see here, okay, for example, here we have Los Angeles, California. So as you can see here, dia bulatkan, dia circlekan, okay, dua. Okay, before that, the first one, this one is the release mark. Okay, release mark menunjukkan, okay, surat ini telah dibaca dan dijawab. Dan pastikan yang kedua, tadi ingat tak, kita kena ada tarikh. Okay, now is the coding. Coding kita akan lihat kepada on the geographic units. So, this geographic units, okay, kita ada Los Angeles, California. So, California will be the main ataupun the major geographic unit. Los Angeles is the subdivision geographic units. Okay, that's why California 1. And then Los Angeles is number 2. Similar macam Malaysia, contohnya Batu Pahat, Johor. So Johor akan jadi the filing segment, the first unit. Okay, whereby the Batu Pahat akan jadi second unit. Itu maksudnya negeri dan daerah. Alright. So the next one, after we have rank in the order, okay, what we need to do, then we look into the correspondent name according to alphabetic indexing rule yang kita belajar, master, rule number, rule 1 until rule 7. So, as you can see here, nama dia Miss Edna Buman President. So, from here, you need to do the indexing for this name, okay, plus with this name. Remember, untuk geographic filing method, kita ada geographic units. Dalam masa yang sama, kita ada indexes. Okay, indexes di mana kita perlu additional nama korespondent. Okay, and you need to use the diagonal line to separate the filing units and number them to choose their indexing order. So, kat sini, not only they're using the personal name here, tapi dia guna juga business name di sini. Alright, as you can see here, business name di sini. Alright, cuma susunan dia akan, this one is a business name, this one adalah nama country, the geographic unit. So California akan jadi the main one, item number 2, okay, nama company daripada kiri ke kanan. So dia 1, 2, dia kiri ke kanan, Simplex Supplies Incorporation, 3, 4 dan 5. Okay, kenapa dia jadi 3, 4, 5? Sebab dia continue daripada geographic punya filing division. Alright? So, we use the diagonal line just now. And the second step is you need to prepare the cross-reference if there is have a cross-reference here. So, as you can see here, okay, in the letters here, we have macro office supplies. Okay, macro office supplies as a main heading of this business name. Dalam masa yang sama, kita jumpa nama company lain dekat sini, Simplex Supply Incorporation. That's why dalam indexing cross-reference di sini, kita ada letak name of the subject, this one. Dan dia akan referring kepada tarikh surat. Okay, ini adalah tajuk surat. C, you nampak dekat sini, itu macro office supplies. So, dia ada dua nama. Okay, dia boleh refer kepada dua. So, kalau kita cari this file tak jumpa, dia suruh lihat kepada this name. Alright? So, this one, you may refer back on what you had learned in chapter 4. Okay, and then we will put here lah in the guide plan. Alright? So, step number 4 in the filing procedures for geographic is we do the sorting. Sorting means that here we will arrange by the geographic units. Okay, begin with the major geographic units and then continue with the other units, small units that have in the filing segment. Alright? So, for example here, okay, dia bagi contoh, kita susun mengikut state nama dulu, okay, and then barulah city, dan kemudian yang ketiga adalah the name of the correspondent. Alright, and last one, definitely, we need to do a filing, at which we will do a labeling and a guide as follow. Alright, this one, you can, read at your own, okay. But remember that for the guides, you must know whether you want to use the dictionary arrangement or encyclopedic arrangement. Tapi kalau you ada lebih daripada satu filing unit, geographic filing unit tadi, so automatically you will have to use an encyclopedic arrangement. Alright, and the expansion of geographic filing is actually this readily accepted and can be reduced and expanded with the relative case. Maksud dia, dalam geographic filing ni, kita boleh tambah dan tambah ataupun buang, kurangkan file mengikut negeri ataupun mengikut daerah sebagai contoh. Okay, the alter filer know when to change, the changes in the system are necessary and how to make them. Tapi dia kena tahu dalam filing system dia susah mengikut susunan dictionary ke encyclopedic. Mengikut daerah apa yang ada untuk negeri-negeri yang di bawah operation that company. So here, when to expand, at which the changes will occur as the continuation of business transition of the year. And whether you believe or not, the first year of the operation of the company, you akan ada only a few of the records. Tetapi bila when it's come year by year, dia akan bertambah. Okay, for example, like you expanding the business punya operation. Alright, so this, the increase of the volume of the incoming outgoing records processes for the filing will indicate that you need to expand your filing system. And somehow, there will be overcrowded. Overcrowded means that mungkin folder tu tebal dan sebagainya. That will require you and the need, there is a need for the expansion. And how to expand? As simple as you put, you need to know, okay, contohnya, sebelum ni company you tak ada buka cawangan di daerah tu. So, bila ada buka cawangan daerah tu, automatically file akan dibuka. So, bila file dibuka, you kena tahu daerah tu duduk dekat negeri mana. So, bila tahu duduk dekat negeri mana, you tahu nak cari guide di bawah guide mana. Contohnya, you nak expand your business di Johor, di daerah Pontian pula. So, you know that file will be created and that file will put under Johor, di belakang Johor dan disusun mengikut susunan district alphabetical order. Alright? So, that's all from me. And this will be the advantage and the disadvantages. Okay, advantage that, before I forget. Okay, the advantage that you, the advantages when you use the geographic filing method is actually, you can do the assessment ataupun you boleh analyze, alright, to group your business according to location. Contohnya, you boleh grupkan, okay, ini saya punya perniagaan di bahagian negeri Kedah. Ni bahagian Perak dan sebagainya. You boleh group that according to the state. Okay? And the operation relating to specific location are filed together. bila kita dah dah group kan, so apa-apa file berkaitan dengan that particular location, contohnya Johor, so dia akan letak dekat satu tempat. So kita nak, bila kita nak assess information berkaitan dengan business performance untuk kita punya apa ni, perniagaan di Johor, so kita assess on the under guide Johor. Alright, so each geographic area in the storage is a unit of the group, and the shift of the groups of the record is easily accomplished by moving an entire group from one location to another. Okay, dia tak, dia lagi mudah berbanding numeric dan sebagainya. Sebab apa? Bila kita dah groupkan dia kepada satu tempat, contohnya, okay, ini Johor. Daripada Johor, contohnya ada 5 cawangan. So, di belakang Johor tu, dia akan ada 5 file. So, bila kita nak arrange, nak bawa keluar, kita akan cari dan kita ambil dekat satu, daripada satu tempat sahaja, ataupun daripada satu drawer sahaja. However, the disadvantages actually, it's require the time for you to prepare and also to maintain. And remember, untuk orang yang bekerja, staff yang bekerja yang maintain, perlu tahu geographic location yang diguna pakai dan juga the index perlu dihasilkan. And last but not least, guide and folder arrangement for the same large system are very complex. Meaning that untuk sistem pemfailan yang sangat besar, bila you guna geographic, dia agak sukar dan agak rumit. Okay, at which you can arrange accordingly. That's why certain company, dia mula-mula dia buat by zone. Bila company makin besar, zone maknanya zone utara, zone selatan, tapi bila makin besar, dia akan pecahkan jadi negeri-negeri-negeri untuk lagi mudah. Okay, that's all for me for chapter number 5. Okay, so the next class we are going to cover chapter 5.3. Okay, on the subject filing method. Okay, with that, thank you. Assalamualaikum.